हेलो, गुड मॉर्निंग फ्रेंड्स. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू कंटिन्यू विद द सीरीज बेस्ड ऑन द हिस्ट्री ऑफ इंग्लिश लिटरेचर. टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस द हिस्टोरिकल बैकग्राउंड ऑफ द एज ऑफ चासर एंड द वेरियस फॉर्मेटिव इन्फ्लुएंसेस एंड द वेरी सिग्निफिकेंट इवेंट्स दैट लेड टू द डेवलपमेंट आर डिवास्टेशन आर to the protest and revolts of the or the revolt of the people. And in the later part we'll discuss Chaucer, his biography, and other contemporary writers of the age of Chaucer and their contribution towards the development of the literature and various aspect of our language. In the f f in this first lecture I'll confine my topic to the biographical detail and the discussion on the historical events in detail and in a very pithy and vivid manner. So guys, without wasting, because in the later part I have to discuss the various characters and important and significant characters and the thematic concern and and irony and the objectivity of the Chaucer in the poem and reflection of the 14th century society in the age of in Canterbury Tales. So guys, without wasting our time, let's get straight to the topic. Historical events that are very in that proved very significant in towards the development of so many movements that led to the Reformation and the humanism. These events were proving to be are setting the background for the major events and that we'll see in the ensuing lectures. So guys, you might have listened about Black Death, because the age of Chaucer, let me tell you that age of Chaucer, basically age of Chaucer begins from 1340 to 1400. Why the age has been categorized, or why the age has been given the date 1340? Because the age is ascribed, or the age is known for the most famous and the first recognized and the writer who gave currency to our language was Chaucer. He was born in 1340, though there is conjecture that he was born in 1343, but according to the various sources, that Chaucer was born in 1340 and he died on in 14th century or 14 when sorry he died in 14th century, and that is why the age is called Chaucer age. So let's once again get straight to the topic, which is historical events, because without having a proper understanding of the historical events, we won't be able to understand with exactitude that and the significance of the Canterbury Tales, which is the magnum opus not only of the Chaucer but of the realistic literature. So guys, you might have learnt about Black Death. Black Death, basically it was a bubonic plague, like we have this pandemic, we have this COVID-19. It was a bubonic plague that spread from the dead mouse. This disease was very fatal, because there was hardly any advancement in the medical science during that time. So this disease spread like wildfire, and it swept away one third of the population of the Great Britain. So guys, you have to understand it minutely, that what was the impact of the this Black Death on the people. Because the age was primitive age, and there was hardly any advancement in the vaccination sector, in the medical science, and large number of population was swept away. So what is impact of this pandemic on literature? What is impact on the age? I am going to discuss this here, that the impact of this all this age is basically when this Black Death broke out, at the time population was minimized because there was a large rate of fatality rate or the death rate. So there was a huge gulf, or there was a huge scarcity or dearth of labor. When there was scarcity of labor, at the time there was the necessity for labor was enhanced. The necessity for labor was enhanced. People were made to work more, because earlier on the work used to be done by 20 people. Now the same work is to be done by 5 people. So how can you justify one thing or the one aspect? So people were forced, because there was no concept of human rights at the time. People were forced to labor for more and paid for less. So people had to work for 10 to 15 and 18 hours, and they were just given the staple food, or the amount for the staple food. So guys, this also impacted, and it led to the peasant revolt of 1381. What is peasant revolt? Basically, peasant revolt is a very significant event in the history of the humanity, rather, when peasants of Great Britain protested against the very minimal charges and the meager charges that were wages that were paid to the labor, because the intensity of the workload was too much. So peasant revolt also have a formative influence, and we'll see the impact of the Black Death and peasant revolt and the innuendos towards these events in the Canterbury Tales from the characters. In connection with Black Death, there we have a Doctor of Physics, and connection with peasant revolt, we have their Miller, we have their so many characters. So guys, peasant revolt was the direct consequence or corollary of Black Death. Because Black Death swept away the population, the need for but labor and the number of the laborer was less, so they were forced by the circumstances and by the monarchical government to work more and then to be paid very less. So people revolted against this, and this led to the peasant revolt. And why peasant revolt? Because there is in other you can say backlash. Peasant revolt happened because England engaged for a very long time with France on various territorial issues. And the king and the queen and the royal family and the people belonging to the royalty are having proximity with the royalty. They were living a debonair kind of life, life of voluptuousness, life of luxury, life of satisfaction, and where there is no want, where there is no longing. But unfortunately, it impacted the life of the layman and the common man. This is the first reason, and the second reason is that people, because of the engagement of England with the France on various territorial issues and the wars, people, thus government or the official exchequer was ransacked, and it was almost exhausted. And now people were levied with heavy taxes. So Jack Straw is the main person who is the precursor of this movement, and John Ball. Later on, John Wycliffe also joined the movement. And this peasant revolt, once again, in the form of reformation, that we'll discuss in the ensuing lecture.